What's up, everybody? This is Major coming at you with another kind of cool video. It's early. I've been up since 4:15 a.m. Time is short, y'all. So you got to get it. Whatever's going on, you got to get it. And what I don't mean time is short. The end of the world is going to be tomorrow. I didn't say that. I meant just the days are shorter. You got more stuff to do, so it makes the day a lot shorter. So what do I do to overcompensate for that? You got to get up early. You got to, you can sleep when you're dead. Your body can sleep when it's dead. But yeah, you got to get enough rest to stay healthy. But you'll find out if you do it, you actually have more energy the less sleep you get. And what I mean by that is you have to have an adequate amount. But if you're sleeping 8 hours a day or 9 hours, you're going to feel lethargic and tired. If you're sleeping like 6 hours a day, you pop up with more energy. So that's what I find. That's my opinion. I'm not a sleep specialist or nothing. But yo, this video is about, I wanted to address this because I hadn't hit it yet, but I've been wanting to get into emergency lighting because it's nothing that guarantees that you're going to have power or lights for that matter. So one of the, and you know, not having lights is okay. You can condition yourself to not having lights and not being, you know, just practice for a week. Put some duct tape over your light switches. And every time you go in a room, you got a little piece of tape or even masking tape. You ain't got to use duct tape where you can't flip the lights on. You know, if you got little kids that keep leaving the lights on and making your bill high, put some tape over the switch and see how, I bet they cut your bill in half. Trust that. I've done it before. Y'all know I got kids. So listen, I'm gonna run through this stuff real quick. I'm gonna try to, so I don't have a 20-minute, 30-minute, 50-minute video again. I'm gonna try to run through it quick, but whatever it takes, I'm gonna get through the information so that I can give you just some more options. Remember, prepping, that gives you and creates for you options. It buys time. It gives you time to not. So one, I'm not freaking out. Two, I do have a plan in place for that particular thing. And three, I know how to use it in my plan. That's it. So that's all I'm going to show you. Let's start out with some of the most common emergency lighting features that you may already have in your house. So a candle. So, you know, you do have to consider candles as far as health concerns. You have to consider what type of material is in your candle. So if you get a natural soy candle or something with essential oils, if you're going to get some candles, I kind of feel like that might be better. I'm not a specialist. This information is for information purposes only and is my personal opinion and it's what I do. When I show you some of my stuff, if you see some dirt on it, that's because Major uses his stuff. I don't wait till the impending doom hits or whatever. I'll be using my stuff. And I know I'm using Ebonics, but I'll be using my stuff, okay? So if you see some dirt on it, that's because it was in the trailer. It was somewhere where I already have it stored. I grab this stuff and use it now. So I don't just store it up and then it doesn't get used, because when stuff sits too long, it goes bad too. But anyway, Major uses his stuff all of the time. I use it with my businesses. I use it in the trailer, in the RV, in the other trucks. I keep stuff where I can grab it and use it. It comes in handy all the time, just anyway. So the best candles to get are those that are essential oils probably, and got the soy wax or some type of beeswax or something like that. So you're not breathing in any toxins. I mean, anytime you light something, you're going to be breathing in something. Anytime it gets converted from a solid to a liquid, it's going to be burning off chemical or burning off whatever the thing is. Even natural stuff probably has some toxicity level to it. But anyway, you know, it's like a three wick candle. These I found, we were at Marshall's one day. Y'all know y'all been to Marshall's. I don't go shopping that much, but if I do go in town and get to a Marshall's, which is an hour and a half away, hour 45 minutes away, then I'll pick up a bunch of these, you know, candles. They're like, what was this one? $12. I think that's a pretty good price because it's a big candle. I've used these. I'd use them now to make the house smell good. It whips your frequency, I think. It lifts you up. You smell something, smells real good. It lifts your spirits up. So these are cool. roundabout way, the most basic way to light your home would be with some candles. Always make sure they ain't where kids can get to them. They can tump them over, of course, and spill the wax on themselves, which that would burn. And set stuff on fire. Make sure you ain't putting your candles next to no curtains, anything flammable, okay? Be safe. Use safety. Make sure you up on your safety game. So that's one type of candle. Now another type of candle, I like these a lot, but I don't use them for everyday use. These are specifically used for emergency situations. This is called a 115-hour candle. And the company, let me throw my over 50 specs on. Oh, that's what it says. Okay, now I got it. So this is emergency long-lasting candle. The company's name, Candle Life. You can go to their website, mycandlelife.com. I'll try to remember to put it in the description because y'all been like, Major, put this stuff in the description. I'll try to put that in there so you can check them out. Now, what it has a little plastic top right there, a cap. So let me try to carefully take this off. Pry it out of there, and that's where your wick is. So this is just like a oil lamp, okay? This is the oil in there. It's got the long wick, and when you take it off and light it, that's how you work it. And it's got this little cap on there. I don't know what it's for. I'll have to find out. But basically, you light the wick. You can pull the wick up and adjust it, move it around, so on and so forth. Then when you finish, you can let this cool down. Put the plastic cap back on. So, because if you tump these over and they stay tumped over long enough, then they'll tend to leak a little oil where the candle is because it'll leak. So you need that cap on to keep the oil in. So check this product out, 115-hour emergency candle. You can reuse it, take it with you. It's a plastic bottle. It's kind of cool. When you buy the pack, I think it comes like a dozen to a pack. I don't remember the price. These have been on the shelf for quite a while, so I don't know the price or remember it, but check out 115-plus-hour candles. They're going to far outlast a traditional candle. So these will be extended life candles for you. Same safety precautions. Keep away from children. Keep away from flammable stuff. All right. Now, next, we got the old school lamp. Now, it's a new one, but it's old school. I keep 3 or 4 of these on hand. And the reason why I do, because y'all know oil lasts a lot longer than just wax. It burns a little differently too. So this is the old school lantern. You got your, it's still in the box. It's dusty because it's been up on the shelf. I told y'all, I don't just go buy stuff for these videos. I like already have stuff on the shelf. And this helps me keep in practice showing y'all what you can purchase, because it keeps me moving through my materials. The more you handle your stuff and know where it's at all times, the better off you'll be if you got to use it. So don't think I know everything. Do your own due diligence, do your own stuff, but trust this. You got to know how to use your stuff, and you got to know where it's at, or it ain't going to do you no good. If you get an emergency and you can't go grab the this or go grab the that because you done forgot where you put it, then you up a creek without a paddle anyway. So why prep? So it's more to it than just buying stuff. You got to know how to use it and then where it's at, where you put it. Okay. So this is old school lantern. It's got the adjustable wick control over here. And this is the compartment. When you screw this off, that's where you put your oil. But once you put your oil in there and you let the wick soak in the oil, you'll raise the wick with this adjustment screw over here, and then you light the wick. Take the glass off, light it. Then you put the glass back on, boom, you got lights, okay? So, lights out situation, bad storm come through, trees down, can't get outside your driveway, power companies can't get to you for a week or two, whatever's going on. Y'all know it ain't just that can happen nationwide or worldwide. It's also those localized events that you got to be paying attention to. Dude at the power company that controlled the master switch just fell asleep and forgot the switch was off. I'm just joking, but there ain't no guarantee your light's supposed to come on. You dig? There's no guarantee other than your program. You've been programmed to expect that them lights come on. So that's the only reason why they come on right now, but there's no guarantee. So this is your backup plan. have your own stuff. There's the lantern with the oil. So we're going to move that out of the way. We got that one off the list. Now, I'm going to go over some battery powered lanterns that are pretty cool real quick. So this video might, we're at 10 minutes. So this video might go 20 minutes, but go on and watch it anyway. It's cool. Luminar Outdoor. Hit the like, hit the subscribe. I forgot to say that. What else am I supposed to say for a YouTube video? I don't know. Hit the link. The link's below in the description. Yada, 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 blah, blah, blah. All right. So, bam, you got this Luminar Outdoor Lantern. This bad boy is pretty tight. Only thing I don't like about it is for security reasons. And I'll tell you that in just a second. Harbor Freight, bought this bad boy. I bought two. Buy two of everything if you can afford it. If you can't, just buy one. Later on, you get some more extra money, go get you another of the something. If you drop and break something, you got a backup. That's why it's good to have two of everything. It's all about perspective, everybody. What's important to you? It's not about can you afford it, because some of y'all still going to Starbucks, McDonald's, Taco Bell, whatever, every day. Yeah, you're going out to eat at restaurants every day, and then you're talking about, yeah, it's a little tight right now. I can't, you know, I wish I was like that. I wish I had the, well, you wish you need to change your priorities around. And then wish different. Stop doing the same thing all the time. Break out of the habit. All right? Ain't nothing but a program. So anyway, Harbor Freight. They were $24. But this thing is heavy duty. It's got this big rubber base. So you can set it on something. It's got a this top you can set stuff on top of, right? You can need to set something on something. Boom. I'll put it up there. Okay? I can do that. It's heavy duty enough, and this handle is heavy duty. It ain't no cheap little handle, rickety handle like the other one I'm gonna show you. But check it out. Boom, that's the first phase light. Boom, second phase, you can dim it down. Third, you can go lower. Fourth, a lot lower. Fifth, it's off. So you got different lighting levels to choose from. When you on this bright level and you walking in the dark like this, you're gonna be blinding yourself. So you're not, it's not gonna be the lantern you have your weapon out and you trying to walk and see. This ain't the one. You gonna be blind for sure, because I am right now. So, as a camp light, as a in the house, need to light up a whole room light, and then go to sleep, you know, kind of maybe don't want people to see I'm lit up real good, but you know, you could do. You could actually MacGyver this light. And what I mean by MacGyver, go look at the old show back in the, what was it, MacGyver in the 90s. Go look up the show MacGyver, watch some old series or something, you'll see what I'm talking about. MacGyver could do anything with anything. Take some ballpoint pen, some glue, and a hairpin, and make a damn missile or something out of it. Dude was dope. Okay, I could just see right now, just coming off the cuff, put some dark colored duct tape on one side, right? On one half of this. So the light only shines in one direction. And then that way, if you was walking and holding it, boom, the light's not coming in your face. That's just something Major would do. That's off the rip. I ain't charge you for that. That was just free. So that's one type of lantern you can get. Got these little El Cheapo lanterns too. They're like $5, right? Pop it open, you got lights. Close it, and it goes off. Open, light, close it off. How easy could it get for emergency lighting? It's in the corner, look. Put one in each room of the house, put one in the basement, hang it on the wall so as you come down the stairs, if you just take it off, turn it on and go. Boom, you got lights, emergency lighting. Just start taking care of some of this stuff. You gonna need it, okay? So let's go lights before I get into these other solar lights. So always have, look, the tag's still on there. I got flashlights everywhere. Each vehicle got a flashlight. Each vehicle got a mini flashlight, LED, that I can use. And then the utility of these little clips is so you clip it on the inside of your pants pocket. Clip it in your pocket. Yeah, you're going to look like a school book nerd. At least you won't be in the dark. You know what I'm saying? Go invest $5.99 and get you some decent lights, okay? They don't have $80 and $80 mag lights and stage 2 tactical laser pointer light slash, you know, go bag slash iceberg melter or slash. No, it just needs to be a damn light. So when the lights are out, you can see. If your car is broken down on the side of the road, if you stranded at night and you want to make sure you don't get hit by other cars, you need a flashlight to shine it down. Maybe you're just changing your tire, you need a flashlight. They got different beam settings, all kind of cool stuff, but check those out. This is another Harbor Freight thing. You would think Harbor Freight was paying me right now. Harbor Freight, if you're listening, let me send you my P.O. box. But anyway, here's some more Harbor Freight stuff. I'm a Harbor Freight junkie because, yeah, stuff's so cheap. That's why. They got some decent equipment from use, like buying a Craftsman tool thing. But as far as utility and budget and investment, it's a great place to grab some gear. So anyway, this little light right here, this little light of mine, I'm going to let it shine. Anyway, that's from back in the day, that song. Anyway, because it has a magnet in it. It actually, if I have a magnet, see what I'm saying? Let me move that out of the way so you see it. So it's got a magnet, right? And then you turn the light on. So then you got a magnet positioning, works as a work light. So if you was working under the hood of your car, somewhere you needed some light and extra set of hands, you just stick that under the hood and there's your light, you know? Braun is another Harbor Freight light. This is a little bigger light. I keep this in my emergency vehicle. You know, I got the fire watch company. So we all about lights because we're buildings that have burned down. They're working at locations that you're in dark areas working from one place to the other. So you got to have work lights. So on positioning, angle positioning magnetic work light. So when you stick it somewhere, you're able to turn it in different directions without holding it in your hand. And so that way you can focus on the area. That also has this other light on the top, which acts as just a regular flashlight. So you got this movable handle. You can grip it as a regular flashlight. You can use it as a work light. And it's got a hook built into the back of it so you can hang it as a work light. Now you got the capability of hanging it in or a whole area just with one device. So think of buying stuff that have utility. Don't just buy a flashlight because it looks cool. What can it do for me if I got to work by myself is what you got to be thinking. How can I position this light? Look, this one got the magnet on it and this big old clip. So check this out. Even to my jacket, and I don't need to hold it with my hand. I got a light. I can. It's got features that allow me to go hands-free. So now I got my hands ready for something else. The most expensive light, but it's a decent light. These were only, I want to say $17, and it's heavy. It's not like flimsy plastic. It's got if you hit somebody with this, if you had to use it, you could use this as a mini coup baton thing. That joint, it doesn't have a piercing end, but if you hit somebody with this, it's going to hurt. Can I use this thing multiple times? I just showed you. It's a light. It could be a self-defense item. It has a magnet. It has a clip that you can use to hang on clothing or somewhere. This thing got 4 or 5 uses already. So before I get to the next ones, make sure you got plenty of batteries. Keep them in a package if you can. You got batteries. You got different sizes. You got 9-volt batteries you need. You need D. You need C cells. If you got any optics on your weapon systems, you're going to need stuff as I'm there. I don't do this all at once. I pick up different things while I'm there, so I got it. So you're not going to be able to run out and in a emergency situation go get batteries. You might need disposable lighters. Those are going to come in handy too. Not necessarily going to hold it all day and make a light, but this might start a fire for you, of course. It might do other things like some candles. If you get the extended lighters, that's even better. I got a pack somewhere. I couldn't find them. I got them all spread out. I keep one of those in each vehicle. You need to keep in your go bag or a survival item that you need to keep with your prep. I wanted to show you that. Also, check this out. We're going to get into the solar light stuff. You're getting so accustomed to stuff that you think that you got to have this. And when you buy this, it's only going to work for this. I told y'all got to be like MacGyver. You got to be able to take something and create more utility out of the same item. If it don't come with the utility, you make some more utility out of it. So, y'all know about these. I ain't even got to tell you. I don't think it's going to come on because I'm in the light. When you're inside a lighted area, the lights won't, it just see it. So, these have been charging up. I keep them all around the house anyway in the landscape. But I also keep some in the RV and in my other go trailer. Just for landscape, it makes your house look pretty. Now, this is light. It's portable solar lights. If I unscrew this, then let me just play like I moved it out of the way. I could then turn this upside down, right? When I need to use it. I could put a zip tie around this part and hang it from the ceiling, okay? And adjust this solar panel and move it. And then I could also put a zip tie around this area and put some zip ties together, and I can hold this light probably sitting here like this. So if you had to use one of these, which keep buying one or two every week from Wally World, if I go to the local Walmart, we do have a Walmart out here. It's probably a Walmart everywhere on every corner. One, they're like $7.99. It's like 20 lumens LED, and then you got the little solar panel. Deconstruct this light and take some stuff and move some stuff. You got a solar panel with a wire and a light. You could rig these onto the side of the house. You can maybe extend the wire and take the solar panel off, extend the wire, right? You can modify it, put the light in the house, and have a panel outside in the sun. So even if you had a power outage, you could flip these on at nighttime and then have some lights in the house. You ain't got to keep these in the landscape. I bet some of y'all be out there without power. What am I going to do? And you got your whole house lit up with landscape lights, solar power landscape light, and never thought I could just go get one of them and use it. I buy these to use as that. I got enough for the landscape. I don't really need somebody to see my house lit up anyway. These are bought by me for emergency lighting. So that's an option for you. $7.99, solar panel, light, and a switch. Oh man, in America, this is the only place you can do stuff like this. I'm serious. You can't buy this overseas, and ain't nobody buying that in a third world country or a country that third world countries are not bad, by the way. You know, maybe with the stuff that we got headed this way, I don't know. But it's just they're not American, so they say third world. Anyway, I'm going to keep rolling so we can keep this video a little short. And this like I said, I'm not going to put it in the description. Y'all know where Walmart is. But it's called a solar sensing wall light. Now, I just grabbed two of these I had charged, and I keep two. Hang on, let me show you. In the backyard, on the tree. Now, as you can see, so I've got something wrong with the first one. So this is a good test. I can replace that one because it's not working. But you can see, as soon as I walked, I'm about literally 20 feet away from that one, and it kicked on. It kicks on, see? If someone was walking through my yard and came by one of these lights, this is what's gonna happen to it. It's gonna kick on. Where I'm in the back, got the lights on. So these lights right here are cool because they actually work as light and security. So for example, your regular solar lights, they just come on. When it gets dark out, they'll just come on from the charge they had all day. These right here are charging with the little solar panel up here, but these are cool because you can position them how you want them. There's a little hole here so you can hang them on nails. You can put on fencing, on trees. You can put it in your house. Square that you can take the tape off and stick that to something. I had a truck before. Just stick them up there and they charge all day. And when you need them at night, you turn it on, they'll come on. So you got a couple of settings. Like you could turn it on, and it's not going to let me turn it on because I'm in and did it. When you turn these on, okay, there we go. When I close the panel up, then the lights come on. See how bright that is? That's dope. Hang on. Turn some lights off in here. That's your first. This is how they look when you turn them on. Now, let me see. Oh, it's going to stay on? Nope. Do that. Motion sensor light. So your dim light would be, let's see, let's get it to go off. And now this one's coming on in my face. This is how it typically stays on. It's like a sub light, let's say a sub setting. And then when it feels something in front of it, whenever that is, it'll get brighter. Let's see if we can just do it generically. All right, bam. Outdoor lights. You can buy them other places, but they're more expensive, I hate to say. I don't rep Amazon, but it's just an easy way to you know, get some stuff quick, I guess. It's a way to have emergency lighting in your house in the event of an emergency. So I'm finishing this. This video is done. Went too long, son. So we're going to finish up. If y'all have any questions, hit me in the comments. Look, get prepared. We running it, gearing come run up on springtime. Y'all know these weather events been so, all them tornadoes that just went through Kentucky, went through the Midwest, killed folks, tore up factories, tore up stuff, and then ended up in Kentucky and did a whole bunch more damage. Don't be so short memory, America. Y'all forget, like, y'all don't hold nothing, because the movies done programmed you to go from cliffhanger to cliffhanger, from action scene to action scene. So when something real happened, you like, hope everybody's okay, and then you go about your business. Yo, we running up on that again, springtime, bad weather time. We don't know what's going to happen. You might be tornado season and tornadoes and snow and summer, and who knows what's on, everything's on the table. So get your house in order. I'll be back at you with some more videos soon. Boom, I got a lot of energy today. I'm about to get some stuff did. Update this farm shares thing. I'm taking my time with it. I don't know how much time I got to take, but that's something I can't rush into, I see. All y'all keep dropping comments. I got you. I'm going to go through. We're going to pick out all the ones that say they interested. Boom. We'll be hitting you back from the go. Leave your information. I got to put a farm shares website up so all of that stuff can be set, because that's getting to be a mess. So I'll have that stuff updated soon. Yo, this is Major. I hope you found this information well and that you can use it. If you got one thing that Major says that you can use and it benefits your life, boom, job done, son. Job done. Appreciate y'all. Hit the like, hit the subscribe button. It's cold out here, so my words are slurred. Trying to stay warm. I didn't have the heat on in the rig, so I'm just doing this out here early in the so-called day. So anyway, appreciate y'all. Hit that like, subscribe button. Drop some more comments. I'll talk to y'all in just another minute or two on the next video. Peace.